In the beginning, there was only the Creator. He was there then, He's here today, and He will still be here forever. He spoke the heavens and the earth into existence. He created the sun, the moon, the stars, bugs, plants, and animals. Creatures that walked, crawled, and swam, He created all things. When He looked on all that He had made, He said that it was good. Then, He created man and woman. Their names were Adam and Eve. When He looked on them, He said that above all His other creations, they were very good. Everything was perfect. Everything was pure. There was no sin, no pain, no darkness, not even a thought of it. They lived in a beautiful garden that the Creator had given them, and He walked with them and talked with them. But then, one day, that all changed. You see, there was only one rule in the garden, only one thing that the Creator told them not to do. Do not eat the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For if you do, you shall surely die, He said. The tree of the knowledge of good and evil was in the midst of the garden, and in the garden lived the serpent. Now the serpent was more crafty than any other creature. One fateful day, the day that the world changed, the serpent found his opportunity. He spoke and said to Eve, "Did the Creator really say that you cannot eat this fruit? Surely you will not die. You will only become wise, like him." Eve doubted the Creator, and so ate the fruit, and so did Adam, who was with her. And then, it all began. Or should I say, it ended. Immediately, Adam and Eve felt ashamed. They suddenly became aware that they were naked and tried to hide from the Creator who sees all. Because of their doubt and disobedience, they were cast out of the beautiful garden and cursed. Life outside the garden was no longer beautiful, peaceful, and pure, no longer light, no longer perfect. Instead, there was darkness, sin, shame, heartache, and pain, and worst of all, separation from the Creator. Yet, even though they were separated from the Creator, He still loved them with an everlasting love and was still watching over them. His love was so strong that from the descendants of Adam and Eve, the Creator handpicked His chosen ones and made a way to draw them to Himself. The chosen ones were placed in the world to live among the sons of darkness. They were put there for a purpose, to in time be drawn to the Creator and to bring Him glory. But that journey to the Creator was full of hardship and pain. There would be murder, adultery, coveting, sexual immorality and theft, wickedness, impurity, malice, anger, and strife, deceit, sensuality, envy, slander, foolishness, and pride, evil desires, obscene talk, and worship of other gods. At times, even the chosen ones would participate in these acts of darkness. But at the right time, the Creator would give them a key. What was the significance of this key? The key is the Creator's one and only Son, Jesus. Sent as a baby, born of a virgin in the world of darkness, as a sacrifice for sin. Sent to make a way for the chosen ones to have access once again to His Father, and to save them from what they truly deserve, eternal hell. The sons of darkness hated Jesus. All that was in Him was light and good. So they tortured and beat Him, mocked Him, and hung Him on a cross to die. His Father, the Creator, had willingly sent Him out of love, and He willingly died for the sins and disobedience of the world out of love. So on that cross, He died, and later, He was buried. You may think that this is the end of the story, but miraculously, 3 days later, He rose from the dead and went to be with His Father, the Creator. What the sons of darkness did not know was that if the chosen ones confessed with their mouths and believed in their hearts that the Creator God raised the Son of Light from the dead, they would be saved. And through the Son of Light, Jesus, and His death, they would gain access to the Creator once again. chosen ones, upon receiving this key, became the children of light. And these children of light, these chosen, holy, and beloved ones, were called to be compassionate, kind, humble, and meek. To bear with one another, forgive each other as the Creator had forgiven them. They were to put on love, which binds all things together in perfect harmony. They were to let the peace of the Son of Light rule in their hearts. They were to be thankful and let the words of the Son dwell in them richly. They were to teach and admonish in wisdom, to sing with thankfulness in their hearts to the Creator. In whatever they did, in word or deed, they were to do everything in the name of the Son of Light, Jesus, and give thanks to the Creator through Him. This is still true for you today. You can have access to the Creator through the Son of Light, Jesus. You can be a child of light. Accept the key. Open the door. Experience and rest in the steadfast love of the Creator God. This steadfast love gives us access to Him. It is firm and trustworthy. It is a refuge, a safe place. It has been here forever. It brings us joy. It brings comfort to us in knowing that the Creator's steadfast love is faithful through trials and there when we are in trouble. It delivers and saves us. It surrounds us. The earth is full of it. It brings us hope. It extends to the heavens. It is precious. It preserves us. It is merciful. It will meet us. It is good. It endures, and it is better than life itself. Now, you chosen ones, you children of light, welcome to the fortress of steadfast love. And to you, chosen ones, still in darkness, I pray you will find the key and walk in the light. So, what is preventing you from experiencing God's steadfast love? Do you even hold the key?